Kaguya-sama Love is War is a fantastic show. It has some great animation, and all the voice actors do a great job at portraying their characters. Outside of the technical aspects of the show, the semi-episodic nature kept the show digestible and fresh with a variety of different gags. I say semi-episodic because each episode is split into multiple parts with no natural transitions. Though there is an overarching narrative, and we can see that in the finale of the show. However, because I don't watch anime weekly, I didn't really want to participate in discussions about it, and I had to take people at their word. But no more. No longer do I have to listen to the lies of Evanito blaspheming Kaguya's name by calling Chika best girl. Today, I will put the arguments to rest with definitive evidence of why Kaguya is the best girl. It's easy to get distracted by Chika, and I'll fault no one on that front. The dance at the end of episode 3 was something that I looked forward to from before I even started the show.
I'm strapped up, nigga, fuck a gun lock. See me walking with a limp, that's my gun walk. I don't do no arguing, I let the gun talk.
You have no idea how many of the cosplay covers of this dance I watched. However, this is Chika showing her hand. And when you take a closer look at the rest of her hand, you realize there's not much left. Sure, Chika's kinda cute, and she's got some big ol' large breasts. And believe me, that ain't a bad thing. But she's also the biggest nuisance in the entire show. She's called the element of chaos for a reason. If it hadn't been for Chika, Kaguya and Miyuki would be much closer than they currently are. There's one specific story that I think highlights both the flaws of Chika and the strengths of Kaguya. The episode in question is when the principal of the school brings the student council some cake as thanks for some of their hard work. Ishigami asks if he can have a piece and, after getting approval, takes one and eats it, leaving only one piece left. This creates the main conflict between Kaguya and Miyuki. Neither of them can take the cake when the other offers because it shows weakness, and the one offering would be the winner of the battle. After fighting about it for a while, they finally come to a compromise. They would feed each other the cake. Right before they're able to, however, Chika shows up to scold them for fighting and eats the cake that they were about to feed each other.
This shows just how selfish Chika truly is. She masks her want for the cake as punishment to Miyuki and Kaguya for fighting, and she ends up becoming the winner for that day. From a basic understanding, you could also call Kaguya selfish because she seemingly only wanted to give the cake to Miyuki to further her relationship with him. And I'm fully aware of this position, but let's take a look back at that scene and see if that's truly the case.
We know from previous episodes that Kaguya and Miyuki have feelings for one another, but refuse to confess. And the more we learn about each character, it becomes clearer that these feelings these two have are true. During their argument about the cake, Kaguya reveals some information that almost anyone else would have forgotten about Miyuki's past, showing she truly does care for him. So, even if her underlying goal is selfish, she's still being selfless in giving up something that she wanted to give to the one she likes.
Now, I think I've proven my point that Chika is just selfish, whereas Kaguya wants to make the one that she loves happy. So, if you still don't think Kaguya's best girl, then I really don't know. You want more evidence? Fine.
Kaguya is the vice president of the student council. Chika is the secretary for the student council. Now, obviously, these positions are very different from one another and entail completely different types of work. But I don't remember seeing Chika doing any work at all. She would just come to the student council room to goof off and hang out with her friend Kaguya. Kaguya, on the other hand, does so much work for the student council. We see her multiple times handing in paperwork, helping students with problems they have in their daily lives, and other things befitting of a student council vice president.
Not only that, but she does it all without praise. So if nobody else is going to thank Kaguya, then I will. Thank you, Kaguya. All of your hard work has not gone unnoticed. There. Now that should satisfy all of you if you still thought that Chika was best girl. But just to be on the safe side, let me put in one last piece of evidence.
Just look at how cute Kaguya is when she's sick. And now just look at how beautiful she is when she's not sick. Absolutely breathtaking. You can go ahead and add Kaguya to the list of waifus because boy oh boy has she captured my heart.
You know what? The more I think about it, the more I think it's a good thing that you guys like Chika over Kaguya, even though Kaguya is objectively the better choice. The less of you there are, the less that I have to share. Of course, that's only if she decides to give up on Miyuki, because I would never get in the way of the one she truly loves. I have to give a huge shout out to Evanito and his Waifu Wednesday series. I don't normally make videos like this, or even upload on Wednesdays, but he just inspired me because of how wrong his opinion was on Best Girl. Of course, I'm only joking. I highly recommend you check out his video, which I will leave on screen and in the corner, whichever corner it is. As always, thank you for watching, and if you liked the video, be sure to leave a like down below and subscribe to see more videos like this. Maybe. I don't know, we'll see. I'm kind of having fun making this one. Be sure to check out my podcast, which is also down in the description, The Two Dweebs. As always, guys, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.